CataractCoach.com. Phaco aspiration of lens milk. So intumescent white cataract is liquefied cortex. Here's how you can aspirate it. Now, we've shown something similar to this before from a previous guest surgeon, but this is an intumescent white cataract. You can see how liquid-filled that capsular bag is. Look at the pressure within it. So that's putting in viscoelastic. Now going in with this needle, and the needle's on your aspiration line. That's the aspiration line. The inflow is the right hand. That's just the irrigating cannula. So at the same time, stepping on the foot pedal and piercing the lens cap so you can suck out or aspirate that milk. Now you can do this also with a syringe, and we've shown Lukan Mishev who does that, and we've learned that technique too. But in this situation, you have it automated so your foot pedal can control the aspiration. And so you're able to aspirate up enough of that lens liquefied cortex, that milky fluid, so that it's less pressurized. You can see here now, as he starts the capsulorhexis, the capsular bag has been depressurized. You can see the reflection of that light, how it creates an indentation there. So this capsule is not in any risk of running out. So now using these micro forceps, and again, the micro forceps are helpful here because you're just operating through a paracentesis. So there is no main phaco incision yet, just a small paracentesis on either side, and here creating a capsulorhexis. Now, we've featured a lot of videos from our friend here, Dr. Val Apostolov from Amsterdam. So he's starting off here with just the first baby rexus. So making the small rexus first, and then we can go ahead and enlarge and have the final rexus at the end here. So double rexus technique here. Now going in, soft cataract just with bimanual, larger gauge irrigation and aspiration, and simply just aspirating out that lens material. This cataract is not a dense white cataract. It's a soft, fluffy, intumescent white cataract. And so that's all that material is going to be removed very easily. And then afterwards, you can enlarge it. So we've showed all these techniques before, but it helps to repeat them and kind of review them, especially with our newer viewers here. So now aspirating all this out comes out pretty easy. And then we'll do is enlarge that rexus. Now, we've shown in the past you can enlarge it before inserting the lens, or you can actually enlarge it after inserting the lens. So sometimes it can be more challenging to remove some of this cortex if you don't enlarge the rexus because you're operating through that smaller opening. But here with a bimanual system, you can really get this capsular bag cleaned up nicely. So there's certainly a big advantage if you have a small rexus like this to using a bimanual irrigation aspiration setup. Much easier, much better access than trying to do the coaxial one. You know, in some parts of the world, the coaxial irrigation aspiration is the more common method. That's here in the U.S. And other places, Europe or Asia, you may find that the bimanual approach is a lot more common. But certainly either is fine. Now here's the advantage. Look, the hands were switched. So now the aspirator's in the left hand and the irrigator's in the right hand. And full 360 access, even through that small capsulorhexis, is possible. So I wouldn't leave the small capsulorhexis. I think we can enlarge it to a more reasonable size. And here's that very last bit of cortex. It came out very nicely. So with these intumescent white cataracts, remember, these are the ones that have the risk of that Argentinian flag sign, which is where you have an uncontrolled rip of the anterior capsule rim, and you have a white center and then flanked by two sides that are blue, and that's the Argentinian flag. So here now with the eye just full of viscoelastic, going to go and enlarge the rexus. So holding it first, the rim is being held here with those micro forceps, and then it looks like a cystone is going to be used to help nick the capsule and start the tear. There it is. And now the tear can be done. So here I'll differ from Dr. Apostolov. I'd actually put the IOL in first, if you can, because you can get these rolled up IOLs through that small opening. And then you can tear the rexus right on top of the IOL optic, and you know exactly how big you want to make it. Now certainly Dr. Apostolov here is a very talented guy, and he can still make a beautiful rexus even without the guidance of the IOL that's in the bag. And again, look at that, switching hands. This just hammers home the point. If you're a young resident or doctor in training who's watching this video, you've really got to be able to use both hands. So whatever you do in your daily life, whether it's eating food, brushing your teeth, shaving, anything else, please use both hands. Make sure you're equally adept and capable of using each hand to do each step of surgery. And so here you go. Rex is coming around really nicely. What's interesting is there's still no main incision yet. So you just have two paracentesis incisions, and there is no main phaco incision yet. Because remember, the lens material was so soft, it was removed very easily just with bimanual irrigation aspiration through those two side ports. So now I'm going to finish up the Rex. There it is. That looks beautiful. That's fantastic. And let's see what's going to happen with the lens insertion. So likely we're going to have a new incision for that. And there it is. There's a new incision here at the patient's 12 o'clock. And so inserting the lens looks like a single piece acrylic lens. Going to go right there in the capsular bag. Beautiful result. So however you deal with these intumescent cataracts, I think the key message is to make sure that the intumescent fluid is somehow aspirated and you've depressurized the capsular bag. And check out our videos on cataractcoach.com. They explain everything in a lot more detail.
And remember to go to cataractcoach.com and sign up for a free daily email. We'll send you an email every day with a great video like this and other surgical pearls that'll make you a better surgeon.